Sometimes when you have no idea what to do and how to start a song, I usually go for my voice and this microphone here. And you don't need a superior microphone, just a normal one, so you can record some kind of sounds. And it gives you such a nice starting point. And I want to show you how I do it. So basically I go for maybe drums, which is easy to do. Just use an audio track here. And I use my microphone input. You can see the levels here. And I just start to record some sounds with my voice. So nothing special. And this one here is going straight into the sampler. So just use the sampler and track this in. Now we can delete the audio track and just rely on MIDI keyboard input. So perfect hi-hats. Of course, don't forget to use the velocity sliders here. And duplicate. Turn on the looping. Okay, that's our hi-hat track. And just for the next track, we select the first track here and hit Control and D for duplicate. Now we have the same track twice. We delete all the hi-hats here and I go for some kind of snare. And for the kick drum, we can still use the e-kick, which is pretty nice for kick drums. And maybe add some additional hi-hats here, but with a different offset and a sampler. Maybe another one. And another one. So we can group all these samples here, and we have to use low-cut because there's possibly a lot of rumble in the low end because of the microphone, as you can see here. So we cut this out. And maybe we just use phase 4 to have some kind of bass sound here in the track. So we have a better overview over the whole frequency spectrum. So I'm going for F. Just a deep. So maybe we use also a little bit of quantization, introduce a little bit of shuffle here, and maybe go for this one. Maybe like this. And of course we need some pads, and for the pads I also use my voice sometimes, because voice pads sound most of the times pretty great. And because I can't hold my pitch in the right, I can't sing in pitch basically, I'm using Melda Auto Pitch, and this plugin is free. And as you can see, you can choose here a scale, and they go for minor and F, minor F, and it selects all the right keys in the scale. So every time I use here a microphone as an input, it corrects my voice, basically autotune. So this is how it sounds. And I can also choose formant shift here. So I have a different tonality with my voice, like this. So all I need to have to do is now to record some voices. That sounds pretty nice. Sampler, put this in here. Delete the old track. And now we have some pad sounds here, and I choose a short section here, right click, detect root key, and now you can see what kind of key we have here. It's D sharp 2. Go for textures mode, slow it down to maybe 0, choose a big grain size and a lot of motion. Maybe pitch it down one octave. And I usually try to test if this sample is in the right key just use an instrument layer and add the polysynth. So now I'm using the polysynth as an additional layer to the voice sample here, which sounds great and also gives not a lot of whiteness, stereo spread, just a little bit mixed in to have an additional sound, synthetic sound. And when you turn on here the freezing playhead button, then we can choose a random point inside the wave file. You can easily modulate the voice pad. Now I'm using here the random modulator to change the offset randomly and go for pretty slow. I'm usually using the reverb in front of a delay, because delay is then delaying the reverb, which sounds pretty nice. So because we are in F minor, I think, with the bass here on F, so I'm choosing F minor, but I don't know the keys for F minor, so I'm using the keys for D sharp minor and just pitching or transposing everything up. So I'm using a pitch shifter, and from D sharp to F are exactly two semitones, 1, 2. I'm going for two semitones here and can play now on my keyboard on my black keys. F sharp minor. Okay, this sounds nice. Just duplicate this and maybe just record the session. Thank you. So, as you can see, we have now a nice draft we can advance from, and just with the voice. I know a lot of these sounds are not exactly right position, so I have to fiddle around a lot of for long hours just to find the right positions and so on. But you can see it's a nice starting point for new tracks. Just use the microphone and your voice and you can come up with a lot of new fresh ideas and sounds, and it's a lot of fun actually. The plugin I used was Melda Auto Pitch, and it's for free on the Melda store. I put the link in the description, and I would say have fun with your voice and the microphone. See you in the next video. Bye.